Sayeda Zaynab is remembered for surviving Karbala, for supporting and leading the prisoners, and for starting the revolution against the tyrant Yazid. Throughout the whole story of Karbala, Sayeda Zaynab A.S. shows courage, determination and integrity. Any one of us would fall short of what had to be done. Any one of us would fall short of her legacy. Following her family members' pattern, Lady Zaynab A.S. behaved so courageously before the criminals who killed her brother. They would mock her, her family and religion. They would continuously boast about how they butchered her brother, how this was the will of Allah. When she had to stop before Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad, the governor of Kufa, while she was considered a captive, she expressed despise and disrespect for him. He therefore showed his gloating over her misfortunes by saying, "Thanks to Allah who unmasked, killed and disproved your revolution." In reply, she said courageously, "Alhamdulillah alladhi akramana bi nabiyyi wa tahharana min ar-rijs tathira. Innama yaftadhahu al-fasiq wa yukadhdhibu al-fajir wa huwa ghayruna ya ibn marjana." Thanks to Allah who has honored us with his prophet and purified us from uncleanliness. It is only the lewd that has been unmasked, and it is only the dissolute that has been belied. We are not any of these two. Indeed, we are not any of these two, O son of Marjana. It was these words that were more powerful than swords, spears, and arrows. It was these words that crumbled the foundations of the oppressors. It was these words that turned the smiling faces of the enemies into red and angry ones. Sayyida Zaynab alayhi salam exposed the tyrants and their plan, exposed who the true enemies of Allah were, and how blessed the holy household is to be purified of any impurities and to have the final messenger of Allah from amongst themselves. When he heard these shocking words, Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad had nothing to say. He therefore spoke to inflict pain in his attempt to cover failure and inability to answer. He addressed her and asked, "How do you see that which Allah has done to your brother?" Bravely and steadfastly, Lady Zaynab answered with words of triumph, "Ma ra'aytu illa jameela, ha'ula qawmun kataballahu alayhim al-qatla, fabarazu ila madaji'ihim, wa sayajma'a Allah baynaka wa baynahum, fatahajja wa takhasim, fanzur liman al-falaja yawma idhin, fakalatka umuka yabna marjana." I see nothing but his beauty. These were those who were destined to be martyred. They therefore come to the place where they would be slain. Allah will gather you with them for judgment and sentence you. You will see then who will be the triumphant on the day. Woe shall be on you, O son of Marjana. This is no ordinary lady. How can she be ordinary when she grew up in the lap of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi? How can she be ordinary when her mother is Fatima alayhi salam and her father is Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam? From early life, Lady Zaynab was marvelous in her intellect and wisdom. She had learned the Holy Quran by heart, as well as the Prophet's teachings and sayings in Islamic law. She had also memorized the famous confounding speech of her mother, Lady Fatima, peace and blessings be upon her, protesting against Abu Bakr's usurpation of the Islamic Ummah's leadership. Her father too greatly admired her sharp wit. One day she asked him, "Father, do you love us?" He answered, "Of course I do, daughter. I do love you because you are the fruit of my heart." She replied politely, "Father loves exclusively for the Almighty Allah, while it is compassion which is for us." One of Sayyida Zaynab alayhi salam's famous sayings is, "Alam tasma' ila qawlihi, sami'a Allah liman hamida, fakhaffa Allah li qudratihi alayk, wastah minhu li qurbihi mink." Anyone who intends not to have any other intercede for him or her before the day of judgment, Allah should praise him. Listen to his sayings. Allah listens to anyone who praises him. Hence, one should fear Allah, for he has authority over them, or should feel shy of him, for he is very close to them. This statement, in fact, indicates that she was so virtuous and perfectly connected to Allah. She, a strong woman, and great woman of potential and power, but she wasn't to live forever. The horrific scenes that Lady Zaynab had witnessed in her life did not part from her for even a single moment. Her eyes were always tearful and her words uttered in wailing for her brother and the martyrs. She used to call out the names of her brothers, sons and nephews, and then she would lose consciousness. In this state, she was like a feeble body without a soul, awaiting death, which would be the only relief. She awaited death so as to express grief to her grandfather and parents about all that she had seen. Thus, she was affected by illness one after another, and she had to stay in bed for a long time, suffering the agonies of her ailments. Even in the last sparks of her life, the scenes of Karbala and Damascus were alive before her eyes. However, death came to her while her tongue was glorifying the Almighty Lord, who will take revenge from those who had wronged her. She departed on Sunday, the 15th of Rajab, 62 AH, at the age of 57.